When I was a junior in high school, I began dating my first boyfriend. I was very inexperienced with boys, so I didn't know the red flags you should look for when you first start dating. Everything went fine for the first 6 months or so. We enjoyed each other's company and didn't argue very much, but over time, I began to notice some things he did that I didn't like. He had low self-esteem and was always paranoid that I was cheating on him. He would get mad if I even glanced at a boy while walking through the hallway at school. Worst of all, he was incredibly possessive and hated when I spent time with my friends. After putting up with his crazy behavior, constant yelling, and aggression for way longer than I should have, I finally decided to call it quits. I knew I deserved so much better. I knew if I did it in person, things could get pretty messy and even dangerous, so I decided to break up with him over the phone. Just as I expected, he was furious and refused to accept that we were breaking up. After, he called me lots of terrible names. I eventually just had to hang up the phone. From that day on, he began blowing up my phone like crazy. He would call me at all hours of the night and would leave long, awful voicemails and would threaten me. You're probably wondering why I didn't tell my parents or call the police. I know. I really should have, but at the time, the whole situation was embarrassing for me. A lot of people at school already knew how my ex was harassing me, and I didn't want to bring any more attention to myself. I blocked his number and did my best to ignore him. But then he downloaded an app where you can get a new number for free, and would call me on that. Eventually, I just wouldn't pick up the phone unless I recognized the number. I even had to block him on every social media app. Unfortunately, while I could avoid his phone calls, he was harder to ditch at school. He knew what classes I had and would wait outside of the classrooms for me and follow me around. He even knew where I parked and would be waiting by my car when it was time to leave school for the day. I began parking in different places to throw him off, and I always made sure I had a friend alongside me when I was walking through the hallways. But my ex was persistent, and as the weeks went by, he still wasn't getting over the breakup. He would leave notes in my locker with threatening messages about what would happen to me if I didn't get back together with him. If I didn't respond, he would try to get in touch with me through my friends. All my friends begged me to tell someone and get help, but I was too scared, so I stayed quiet. One week, I had done a particularly good job at avoiding my ex. I had barely seen him, and only from a distance. Maybe he was finally getting over me and was going to leave me alone. I drove home from school that Friday in a good mood. I sang along to the radio and thought about how good it felt to have gotten away from such a toxic person. Now, I could actually enjoy the rest of my senior year in peace. I pulled up to my house and noticed a white package sitting on the front porch. Thinking it was just something my mom ordered from Amazon, I picked it up and took it in the house. When I set it down, I noticed that it was my name on the address label. My birthday wasn't for another couple of weeks, but maybe one of my family members had sent me something early? Excitedly, I pulled the tape off and opened the box. I was surprised to find only a large manila envelope inside. Confused, I unsealed the envelope and dumped the contents out on the kitchen table. I was horrified by what I saw. The folder contained dozens of pictures of me, most of them taken at a distance. One showed me walking my dog at the park. Another showed me and some of my friends getting lunch at a local cafe. There was one picture of me working on homework at the library, clearly completely unaware that anyone was watching me. But the one snapshot that bothered me the most was the one of me sitting in my bedroom. I had headphones on and was listening to music. I thought I was alone at the time. I felt sick about the invasion of privacy. I was furious and a little bit scared. I realized that at this point, things had gone too far. I felt like I might actually be in danger. That night after dinner, I told my parents I had something I needed to talk to them about. I informed them about all of the crazy events over the last couple of months, showed them the threatening notes I had gotten, and finally dumped out the pictures that were taken of me. My parents got really upset and didn't wait to take action. They called the police that night, and an officer came to our house. We filed a restraining order against my ex that said he had to stay within a certain distance away from me. Even the administration at school was informed of the situation and ensured that me and my ex would have no classes together. I was still wary the first couple of weeks after the restraining order was filled. I knew legally my ex couldn't get anywhere near me, but I had gotten too comfortable too quickly last time and knew that my ex certainly wouldn't be afraid to test the boundaries. A month went by and I began to breathe a little easier. I hadn't seen my ex at all. I hadn't received any weird phone calls or gotten any more messages or packages. I still took extra precautions though, like taking in my surroundings when I was alone and keeping my bedroom blinds always shut. I even began carrying some pepper spray just in case. I was still mad at myself for not getting help sooner. I couldn't believe how much quicker this issue could have been solved. One normal spring day, not long before graduation, I arrived home from school and parked in the driveway. My parents both worked until 5, so there was always a couple of hours where I would be by myself before they got home. I was grateful for the alone time since it allowed me time to decompress after a long day at school. I went inside, locked the door behind me, and sat my backpack down before going to the kitchen to make a snack. I decided to pop some popcorn as a treat. I heated up some tea and poured my popcorn into a bowl before heading into the living room to catch up on some reality television. I was so immersed in my show that I barely noticed that an hour had gone by. I groaned. If I didn't start my homework soon, it was going to be a late night for me. I grabbed my backpack and headed upstairs to get started. I sat down at my desk and pulled my books out. I got caught up on reading and began an essay that was going to be due for English in a couple of days. I was trying to think of a good title when all of a sudden my phone buzzed. I picked it up and was startled to see it was from a random number I didn't recognize. I didn't get too freaked out right away. It could just be someone who had the wrong number or some sort of scam message. My heart began beating faster when I saw there was an attachment. I opened the text and saw photos of myself. One was of me walking from my car into the house. Another was of me in the kitchen making popcorn. The last one was of me sitting at my desk doing homework. My heart dropped the second I came to the realization these photos had just been taken. There was someone in my house. I let out a shriek when I heard my closet door swing open. There behind me was my ex, who had been hiding in the closet watching me. He stared at me with the most terrifying expression and told me he missed me and wanted to get back together. In his hand, he held a sharp knife. He told me that if I didn't take him back, he was going to kill me and then himself. I didn't allow myself to process anything. I didn't even think about how he managed to enter my house. I just ran for my life, screaming all the way. While I was about halfway down the stairs, I lost my footing and tumbled the rest of the way to the floor. I hit my head hard on the landing and accidentally bit down on my tongue. I could taste blood in my mouth and could feel it running down my face. The fall made me disoriented and it took me a minute to get back on my feet. My ex used this to his advantage and tackled me, pinning my arms and legs to the ground. I screamed in excruciating pain as I felt his knife slicing across my forehead. I flailed around trying my best to throw him off of me, but he was so much bigger than I was. I screamed as loud as I could for help, even though I knew our neighbors lived much too far away to hear me. At that moment, I heard the familiar creak of the front door opening and the jangle of keys, followed by heavy footsteps. My dad had come home early. I screamed one more time before losing consciousness. I later woke up in the hospital connected to an IV. I learned that my father had been able to overtake my ex and held him down until the police arrived. I had a slight concussion and had lost a lot of blood, so I would have to stay overnight in the hospital for observation. Still, I knew that these things could have been a lot worse. I learned to always trust my gut when it comes to people I'm dating. As for my ex, he was charged as an adult and is currently behind bars. I dread the day that he gets out. Do you think she had a lucky escape? What would you have done? Drop a comment and a like and subscribe. Until next time, sleep tight.